What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the PlayerParticles Minecraft plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. When you play through vanilla Minecraft, particles are constantly surrounding you. Whether it's the bubbles from lava, a downpour of rain, or the smoke from a campfire, they are always present to the player. But what if you want them to really surround you? With the Player Particles plugin, you can revamp your character with customizable particles and shapes. Visit the Player Particles spigot page and press the blue Download Now button in the top right, and then you can save this jar file to a safe location to use in just a minute. While the latest version is compatible with most versions, you can also enter the Version History tab to download a specific version. Head to your Apex server panel and stop the server, and then make sure you're running a plugin compatible version like Paper or Spigot. Afterwards, enter the FTP file access in the left-hand menu, and then you can enter the plugins folder and press Upload in the top left. Drag and drop the Player Particles jar into the right-hand side, and once it is completely uploaded, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. To get started, use the /pp command to open the Player Particles GUI. In the menu, press the Blaze Powder item to manage your particles. Then, in the new page, you can press the Book and Quill to create a new one. This will open a secondary menu, allowing you to select which particle you want to add. You can use the buttons at the bottom to switch pages, and you can select from a large number of effects ranging from fire to fireworks. After selecting the particle, you can then choose the style and occurrence for that particle. Some styles are always active, such as wings or spirals, and others are only going to activate under certain conditions, like dying, breaking blocks, and more. Once you've made your selection, the particle will instantly be available to test out. In addition to setting specific effects, you can also combine a variety of effects at once. To do this, just head back to the Particle Manager menu, and then create another effect like before. This can combine a variety of styles at once to have cubes, spheres, wings, and more. You can use as many or as little as you want. If a particle just isn't suiting your needs, you can also adjust them at any time. To do this, you can visit the Particle Manager menu and then select the one that you want to edit. Once that's selected, a new menu should pop up providing three options. These will allow you to change the particle, style, and data respectively. Once you've made your edits, you can just press the arrow to go back and review your changes. In some cases, you might want to save your configuration as a group for later. This is helpful as both a backup or if you want to switch between different configurations at any time. From the Player Particle menu, click the chest icon and then press the Book and Quill. This will prompt you to enter a group name in the chat, which will save your group for later. Here is a list of commands that will come in handy when using the plugin, but keep in mind you are going to have to either be opt on the server or have the correct permissions in order to use them. As for those permissions, here is a list of the permissions each player will need to use each command. If none of the plugin commands seem to be working, try using the /plugin command to see if the Player Particles plugin is listed. If it doesn't appear, that might mean it's not loaded properly. Make sure the jar file is uploaded into the plugins folder, and that you're running a plugin compatible server like Paper or Spigot. If you're unable to use commands from the plugin, then you might not have the correct permissions. If you want to have access to all of the commands right away, you can make yourself a server operator in the console. If you just want to customize the exact permissions for commands for yourself or players, then you're going to need a permissions managing plugin like PERMS. The Player Particle plugin is what we would call a cosmetic plugin. It doesn't help your gameplay in any way, but it is a fun addition to add to a server to give your players a chance at adding some personality to all of their players. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.